Hi everybody, my name is David Pegler. Welcome to your pre-London outlook for October the 23rd. Let me remind you that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. We're not an alert service. Remember that trading is always very risky business, and do not trade real money until you have a proven track record of success on a demo account. All right, great. Today I want to take a look at pound dollar. We've obviously been in a strict downtrend here, and I'm the first one not to profess that I'm a pound bull right now by any means. So I want to get that out there right now. But I've queued up a weekly chart here that I would like you to address just for the time being, and then put together a little trade plan and tell you a few things that I've noticed developing. Now, I am still a longer term dollar bull, absolutely. But do I think this run is overdone? Yes. Okay, so you know, nothing goes down forever, and just as I'm shooting this video, I'm starting to see a few signs that we're showing some fatigue to the downside. So I wanted to point out the support area on a weekly chart. You know, it's always very difficult to use a weekly chart and then put that into the context of intraday in the next, you know, 5-6 hours. But hey, support to support. So I've drawn this little zone here, and it's very zonal. What I mean by that is it's several hundred pips variation. It's not, you know, blunt support where price just went up to it, rejected it, and, you know, then moved away from it. But you can see that this is a spot where we hesitated for several months, in fact, on and off. Okay, all through you know, the mid-90s and then the late 90s going into 2000. So this was a serious spot around 160 for pound dollar. All right. So with that said, I'll take you to a monthly chart. Yes, a monthly chart here for pound. And what I wanted to show you is just how far we are from the monthly Bollinger Band. Okay, we are a country mile where price is now from the top of the Bollinger Band, okay, in excess of 1500 pips, all right? And on a monthly level, we've very seldom been stretched out like that. Just looking back, and if I just zoom out on this chart, I can look back almost as far as you'd like to see, and I have never seen a monthly candle that's finished up this far from its Bollinger Band. Okay, so the logic is that it, I mean, this is why I'm saying that this is oversold. I'm not a pound bull right now, but I think we're due for retracement here, folks. We've seen support. The credit markets are kind of, you know, de-icing a little bit, meaning that LIBOR is coming down, 2-year swaps coming down. I mean, there's a lot of things to insinuate that we might have a little bit of green on the stock market. I mean, we are 100% bear market right now, but there's a few things out there starting to point to a little bit of upside. So I'm keeping that, you know, on the back burner in my thinking. And the fact that we are so stretched out in this pound right now leads me to believe we're due for a pullback. Is that today, tomorrow, you know, Monday? I'm not sure, but we've only got a week's worth of trading left in this month. And this is a monthly candle, and I would be very surprised to see us not finish this candle up, you know, several hundred pips higher. Okay, just so that we finish it up with a little bit of a wick. Do I think we're going to go back to the Bollinger Band? No ways. All right, anything's possible, but I think highly unlikely. There's still a ton of people short. I'm not telling you to get long on a sustainable basis. I'm just thinking that there might be some long pips to be made. And do I think that there's a sustainable, you know, fire and forget move to the downside today, i.e. dollar strength? That I don't think. I think that's really what I'm trying to say here, is I'm eliminating sustainable dollar longs or pound shorts at this stage. All right, the risk reward just doesn't lend itself to a good sustainable fire and forget move. All right, so I think we could finish up with it. My little green pen is here, kind of in the 65, 66 area. You know, then we'll take it from there. But how does that translate to today? Let me take you to a 2-hour and show you what I see here. You know, any move to the upside that's counter trend is going to be ugly. That's the first thing that you got to keep in mind that nothing is going to be fluid to the upside. It's going to be choppy, choppy, choppy. Every level of resistance is going to be tested, rejected. People are going to be trying to short there. So keep that in mind in your risk management. And I encourage you to take your shot short, because there's plenty of volatility here to glean as many pips as you want on the short side. But look for something, I think today, you know, going up. Look at on this 2-hour MACD, if I just draw it way back here and expand the MACD here. It's a 2-hour chart. Not too many people use it, but I like the 2-hour just because it's the it's kind of the middle ground for me between a longer term trader and an intraday trader, okay? And look at how we've never had, in as far back as I can draw this chart, okay, all the way to the beginning of August, we have not had a MACD that's been this oversold before. What we call at Bootcamp an extreme MACD cross. We have not seen this in you know, the better part of half a year. So you know, that's something to consider as well in terms of being way oversold. Also, we're trying to actually produce the MACD cross right now, okay? And look at how oversold we've been on the stochastic. 2 days we haven't entered in to the overbought area, so, or into the trade zone to the upside. So what I'm trying to say is, hey, look for us to go back to the 2-hour 21 today at around 6,500. I think that's a distinct possibility. Is it going to be pretty? Absolutely not. Let me take you to the hourly. Okay, and you can see that we right at the hourly 21 EMA, and I fully expect this area to be resistance. Okay, the angle and separation here is beautiful. This is a screaming trend to the downside. And really, until that hourly has played out, meaning that we've bounced off it maybe several times and start to form up a series of higher lows, that's only then that I'm going to believe that we can break it. Until that happens, we're pretty much deadlocked between 62 and 63.30. All right, so as much as my bias is switching marginally at the moment, we still have all this resistance to keep an eye on. Also, if I take you to the weekly pivots very quickly, you'll notice that the 2-hour 21, it's not quite overlapping with the weekly S2, but you know, if price moves up, the moving average is going to recede along with price, and you'll probably find yourself getting an overlap in that general area with the weekly S2 and a 2-hour 21 EMA. That, my friends, is going to be a strong, staunch area of resistance, and pretty a fantastic opportunity to take profit if we're lucky enough to get ourselves in some decent long opportunities. Yes, I said long. I'm for it. You know, that's my bias. Like I said yesterday in my video yesterday, I'm 100% flexible, though. I take it as it comes. If price wants to fall, I sell it. If price wants to rise, I buy it. I'm 100% flexible. All I'm trying to say is, especially on that 2-hour chart, seeing a lot of signs that this market is fatiguing to the downside a little bit, not to mention all those credit swaps and LIBOR and things that are starting to come in line, you know, which will obviously help out lending between banks, etc. And we know the correlation between the dollar and the stock market at the moment. So keep that in mind, folks. Trade it on its merits, just like yesterday, but I've established a bit of a new bias today. All right? Keep an eye on that hourly 21 EMA. We have to let that 21 flatten out and price react to it several times. So, you know, something like this is likely to play out, and we're going to have to wear on it and flatten it out before we can break it. We're not just going to march right through there. Okay? And there's going to be people shorting there, including myself, until it breaks, you know? And then, you know, and then we're free to think 2-hour 21, which is, you know, around 6,500. So, good luck further today. This is your pre-London outlook for October the 23rd, and happy trading. I'll see you tomorrow.